Hello friends, today we are going to see the diseases of maize. In that, first is bacterial stalk rot of maize. Causal organism responsible for bacterial stalk rot of maize is Yersinia dissolvens, or it is also known as Yersinia chrysanthemi pathover G. Now we will see the symptoms of this bacterial stalk rot caused by Yersinia dissolvens. In that, the basal internodes develop soft rot and gives a water soak appearance, as you can see in images. A mild sweet fermenting odor also occurs at the time of infection, and it causes due to rotting of inner portion of the stalk. So that's why it's called as stalk rot of maize. Leaves sometimes show sign of wilting and affected plants topple down in a few days. Ears and shank may also show rotting symptoms, and this may fail to develop further and the ears hang down simply from the plant. So these are some particular marks of identification for bacterial stalk rot. Here you can see in images the basal portion and the inner portion of this maize crop is completely breakdown, and there is a mild fermenting odor. That means if you break the main stalk, then you can see and you can smell the mild fermenting odor accompanied by rotting inside the infected portion. Borers play a very important role in development of this disease. This bacterial pathogen is soil-borne, and it makes its entry through wounds and injuries on the host surfaces. These organisms also survive saprophytically. That means this bacterial pathogen can survive on dead tissues of plant debris or previously harvested crops. So these are some survival conditions. Infected plant debris serves as a primary source of infection for this development of this disease. And if you want to control this disease at primary level, you must have to follow some precautionary measures like bleaching powder containing 33% chlorine at a rate of 10 kg per hectare should be used as a soil drenching at pre-flowering stage, so we can avoid the primary infection of this disease. Similarly, planting should be done at proper spacing, then avoid water lodging and proper drainage. That means this Yersinia pathogen, it is a water-loving bacteria, and it may migrate from infected portion to the healthy portion by water films. So you have to avoid the water-logging condition, and proper drainage facilities should be maintained while controlling this disease. Downy mildew of maize. It is also known as crazy top or crazy mildew of maize. And causal organism responsible for downy mildew of maize is Peronosclerospora sorghii. Now we are going to see the symptoms of this downy mildew pathogen. Initially, the chlorotic streaks appear on the leaf, and the white fungal growth is seen on both surface of leaf. That means on upper surface and as well as lower surface of leaf consist of this powdery whitish color mycelial growth. So we can easily identify the chlorotic streaks on lower surface of leaves. And affected plants become stunted and exhibit bushy appearance due to shortening of the internode. So this is the particular marks of identification for downy mildew of maize. That is, the infected plants shows shortening of internode with bushy appearance. Similarly, proliferation of axillary bud is the particular marks of identification, and proliferation of axillary bud on the stalk of the tassel and the corms is a common symptom of this downy mildew pathogen. Here I have mentioned the downy mildew genera, all the downy mildew genera causing downy mildew on various crops. So you can easily see the characters of each and every downy mildew pathogen, and it is made by me, and all the characters are mentioned here For example, if you see the down mildew of grapes, it's having the characters of sporangiophore branching, that is, it is right angle to the main axis. This is the particular mass of identification of Plasmopara viticola, that is downy mildew of grapes. Similarly, now we are studying Peronos sclerospora sorghi, that is, its sporangiophore branching is of sclerospora type and the germination of the sporangia is Peronospora type, and sporangia are spherical without papilla. These are some characters of this Peronos sclerospora sorghi, and it causes infection to the sorghum also and in maize also. Primary source of infection of this downy mildew pathogen is woo spore, which are present in soil, and it also serves as a dormant structure while absence of main host. Similarly, dormant mycelium also present in infected maize seeds. These are serves as a primary source of infection. And secondary source of infection is always by means of airborne conidia or airborne spores. At the onset of growing season, at soil temperature about 20 degrees Celsius, the woo spore in the soil germinate in response to root exudates from susceptible maize seedling. The germ tube infects the underground section of maize plants, leading to characteristic symptoms of systemic infection, including extensive chlorosis and stunted growth. If the pathogen is seedborne, the whole plant shows symptoms. Woo spores are reported to survive in nature for up to 10 years. Once the fungus has colonized host tissues, sporangiophore, that is conidiophore, and sporangia, which are wind and rain splashes disseminated from infected portion to healthy portion and causes secondary infection. Management. For management of downy mildew, you must have to destruct the plant debris, which serves as a reservoir host for survival condition of this pathogen. Similarly, removal and destruction of collateral host. Similarly, growing resistant varieties like DHM1, DHM103, DMR5 and Ganga 2, these are some resistant varieties we can use for cultivation purpose. And if we did the seed treatment with metalaxyl and rate 4 gram per kg, then we can avoid the primary infection to the seed and we can control this downy mildew at primary level. Similarly, if the emergence of this downy mildew pathogen arises at the time of major crop growing phases, then we can also control this downy mildew pathogen by spraying with metalaxyl or any another systemic fungicide which were effective against this downy mildew pathogen. Brown leaf spot of maize. Causal organism responsible for brown leaf spot of maize is Physoderma maize. Now we will see the symptoms of this brown leaf spot of maize. Lesions occur mainly on the leaf but may also occur on leaf sheets, stalks, outer ear husk and tassels, producing small round to oblong or chocolate brown to reddish brown spots which may merge together to form large brown blotches. And these spots also, you can see these spots on midribs are circular and should be dark brown color. Here you can see in images the midrib consisting of blackish colored dots, it showing the symptoms of brown spot of maize caused by Physoderma maize. Here you can see the stalk is completely infected by this brown leaf spot of maize, and the inner midrib portion is completely destroyed due to the infection by this pathogen. For management of this brown leaf spot of maize, we can use the measures which were followed for management of downy mildew of maize, that is seed treatment with metalaxyl, chemical spray of metalaxyl, removal and destruction of collateral host and weed host, use of tolerant varieties, crop rotation, good cultural practices, field sanitation, proper spacing. Such management practices should be followed for management of this downloads part of maize.